Hey everybody, it's Brenda Adelman again. Sorry, I'm going to start actually announcing these Facebook Lives. It's just, I get really excited about certain subjects, and then I want to do a Facebook Live, and then I look at the light outside and I'm like, oh, it's going down. I better go do this now. Anyway, today I want to talk about, though, the importance of silence. Okay, so like right now I'm starting with, oh, I got to go do this. But the truth is, I actually went in silence earlier today and I decided what I wanted to do. And then I got really busy, but I knew that I wanted to share this because it's really important to take our actions from this place of inner guidance and silence and listening for what the next best action is to take. So, again, I am Brenda Adelman. I'm a story coach. I am passionate about helping you, anybody listening to this. Find the story that you're supposed to tell that's gonna freaking change the world, because that's what storytelling does, right? I mean, haven't you ever been touched by someone just personally telling their story, and all of a sudden something opens up inside of you and you realize you're not alone? That's one of the biggest things about storytelling. I also have a one-person show that I've performed all over the world. I have been blessed to be able to perform it in London, Vienna, Los Angeles, Hawaii, New York City, Brooklyn, Michigan, Oklahoma. I mean, the list goes on. And for audiences as diverse as women prisoners, youth at risk, domestic violence coalition, survivors, trainers, mental health professionals, in addition to theaters all over the place, right? And what's so incredible about telling your story in a format like that, like on stage, either as a speaker or as a presenter or leading a workshop, which I've also had the honor of doing. What's great about that is then you can actually give people tools and tips and help them to move past whatever the message of your story is. But there's something about being live in person and feeling the impact of what you've just shared has had on them. It's life-changing, and it's life-changing for me. Like, I was in a conference this weekend attending, and the stories that the speaker spoke about touched me deeply. And the thing about knowing what to share, what I realized with him, he shared some really personal things, like I do. But there were things that had happened a while ago, and what's so important about this is that he already did the inner work so that he's not, telling a story where then when you listen to it in the audience, you're like, you feel bad. Instead, he was telling a story that I know for myself, I could go within and be like, oh, I'm not alone. Oh, I don't have to be ashamed. Oh, I can move past this. Oh, it's time to move on. Like, it was so great. And it was an example of what I teach to people. Like, listening to him was amazing for me because it opens me up. So it's so important that while you want to share your story, you're also out there looking at other people who are sharing their stories. It's really important to share your story also in person, also personally, right? Because there's the one element of sharing your story for your business, and then there's one element of actually translating the story that you come up with for your business, because that's to stand out and to make an impact, but then also being able to share it personally and change people's lives. So I want to talk about, I got off on a tangent. I'm so excited about this stuff. I want to talk about why it's important to go within to find the story that you're supposed to tell. Because I work with a lot of clients and they've lived very big, full lives. That's what I attract. That's what I like. Because I've lived a very big, full life filled with super highs and super lows and lessons galore. And the thing is, I don't share everything I've been through in my business. I don't. I lead with what my life story, I lead with what the theme of my life is, and that's what I teach people. But how do you find the theme of your life story? There's a step-by-step system, but there's also an element of getting quiet enough to realize what made the most impact on you in your life. If it was a big event like what happened in my life, then it's easier. Sometimes it's harder if you've lived through several things. I'm trying to get the lighting better. Sorry, guys. But let me give you an exercise to go within. And actually, I love this. I got this today from the Daily Word.
It's a Unity Church booklet, pamphlet. It's so awesome. They have a different quality each day of the year that you can focus on. And this is what got me to thinking about this today. Today's about inner peace. It says, stillness nurtures peace in my soul. The hectic pace of life may seem to push me to keep busy. Yet, a full calendar could leave me feeling exhausted and at odds with others. So I practice caring for myself by making time to be still. Prayer and meditation are priorities in my day. A moment of gratitude before I get out of bed becomes a seed of peace planted early. I take the opportunity to pray whenever I am with, wherever I am, with whatever time I have available. As I wait in line or move between appointments, I focus on my breath. I slow my breathing. Each cleansing breath calms my racing thoughts. I may whisper a phrase like, peace, be still, to my being. Stillness nurtures peace in my soul. Restored and renewed, I return to my day at peace. How amazing is that to take a moment to read something like that? Because I want to talk to you about finding your story, but I don't want you to do it from, oh my God, look at this big life I had, or reaction. Like, there was this big conference here in San Diego this weekend that was about gaming and pinball and all this kind of stuff. And I remember watching someone playing a pinball machine and thinking, how many of us and how many days have I had where I'm like a pinball going from one appointment to the next, one thing to do to the next? You cannot find your center and what will truly bring you peace and happiness from that place. I invite you to slow down. I invite you to center yourself and be given the opportunity to listen within. What story wants to be told by you? What have you lived through that's juicy, that's right there for you, right? I always tell my writing clients to not, you know, write what's juicy for you. Don't not write it because you have other things that you're off to the races for. Or, you know, my writers who are also not just creative writers but have businesses, they're like, well, I really have juice, I want to write about that, but I don't know if that's for my business. And it's like, no, write it, because you'll probably find gold in there, even if it's like a line or two that you can use on your business pages, right? So how do you get silent? Do you take the time to be silent? What was so great is that I was in a 10-week class on a book called The Presence Process recently, and it included, when we met up, doing 15 minutes of meditation. And then the book actually required 2 times a day of 15-minute meditations, and it transformed my life. It created an opening in me, and I'm sure that's why right now I am experiencing so many miracles. I mean, I'm right in the game as far as, you know, I have my ups and my downs, and yet every day I seem to experience more expansiveness, more loving, more support, more miracles, gifts, opportunities that I couldn't have even seen coming. Almost like magic sometimes, really. So there's the two parts. There's like getting quiet to find your story, and then doing the work, taking the action. Some people stop because they don't take the action. They think about what they want to write about. They even might get an inward guidance, and then they stop. I remember getting inwardly guided. So like I said, I have a big story. My father killed my mother. It's a big story. All of my work is about the message of my story, which is how I forgave him, and how forgiving him, I found myself. I found love again. And then after that, expressing myself boldly and finding my voice and putting it out there and teaching other people to do that. But I've completely lost my train of thought. Is that I actually lost my train of thought live. That's great. I'm glad I'm not on stage right now. But I'm on stage. I'm on stage. You want to know what you, okay, I'm just going to go back. I actually have no idea what I just ended with, but what I will say is that you want to go within, find out what it is. Well, I was talking about action. I was talking about not time. Oh, this is it. I got it back. Great. I was so devastated by what happened with my family that I kept thinking, I want to write this. I want to write this. I want to write this. It wasn't about presenting it to anybody else. I wanted to write it, though. And that was actually my inner guidance telling me that I would heal as I wrote my story. But I didn't follow it for like a good year after my mom died. And I absolutely know my healing would have started sooner if I would have started writing my story down. So if you're thinking about writing your story and you're still really emotionally charged, I'm going to invite you. This is really important. This will change your life. I'm going to invite you to start writing your story now versus later, getting it out of your head and onto the pages of your journal. You don't ever have to share it. This is for you to look at what you've lived through. That's if you've gone through something big, or even if you have ideas and it's not something big, or you don't think it's big, but you've been getting these ideas, maybe even funny things, and you want to write them, but you keep it in your head. Don't write it down on the pages of your journal before you lose it. I think it was Michael Jackson that said that when he got up in the middle of the night and kind of heard these words that he wanted to write down for songs, he would do it because he knew that if he didn't, that God would give the words to Prince, which I thought was really interesting. But it is the difference between people who have their voice heard and are out in the world and those who aren't heard. So it's really important to find your story, to decide whether or not you're going to share it with other people. And if you're stuck actually in writing your story, I actually have a free short report to help you get unstuck. I haven't looked at it for a while, but I know that it has two exercises to actually get you started writing. And one of the most important things, it actually gives you a way to get free feedback, like on your writing. Because that's another thing. That's a really important step if you ever, ever want to present your material to other people, to get feedback on your writing. Because what you have in your mind can be really clear, but sometimes when you read it to someone else, it's not as clear. So it's always important to get that. So if you want to get that free report, it's forgivenessandfreedom.com/spotlight. That's what it is. Forgivenessandfreedom.com/spotlight. That's where you'll get it. And so again, I'm Brenda Adelman, and I hope you'll pick up that report and certainly ask me if you have any questions about this. I invite you to take the time to go within. That was the other thing. Last night, one of the people who was in that 10-week class with me put together a little gathering of those people who were in the class who wanted to kind of come together, meditate, kind of just get out of the doingness of the world and remember why our lives transform so much when we're taking that class on the book study. And we got together and it reminded me just how much I have been experiencing miracles, but how much I have not been creating that open, quiet space, like how much more opportunity I have to do that. Because when I do, my life just, it's just so in the flow. Do you have times like that in your life where things are just in the flow? It's like there, all of a sudden there's no tension. It's amazing. So that's what I'm encouraging for all of you guys too. Okay. So I invite you to slow down. If you want practical tools on how to get unstuck, get the free report. I invite you to get that while it's still up. It's also on my website, forgivenessandfreedom.com, but I'm pretty sure if you then put /spotlight, you'll get it as well. I will see you soon. Have a fantastic day. I'd love to hear from you. I know I put these up last minute, but I would love, love, love to hear from you. And let me know if you have any questions in the thread below. You can also ask me questions about how, you know, what's a good practice for getting silent, listening to your inner guidance. Okay, have a fantastic rest of your day.